guys, it's your boy back with another video, man. Let's get it. Hey, I was told by a buddy to do a video on what I do and what I don't like about my car. So today I'm about to bring you guys the five things that I don't like about my car. So for those that don't know, I drive a 2010 Nissan Altima. So today about to be the five things that I don't like about my car. First things first, Nissan, I don't know what y'all was thinking back in 2010. So my car, the exterior is black. My interior is black leather with black trim. What was y'all thinking putting tan, like two-tone? Y'all got tan here, y'all got tan here. Like, that's like one of the ugliest colors y'all can ever put into a car. And the shit is so hard to clean. Like, any little speck and you see it. Like, you got a dark colored car, why not put like a dark gray or like something dark? Like, why have a dark color and y'all wanna put this light ass color in here? Like, I don't get it. Number two, what I don't like about this car, but I kinda do like it, but then I kinda don't like it, is the transmission. So these cars came with CVT. And originally, with me being a car person, I was all nothing for CVT. Like, I didn't want nothing to do with a CVT. So it kinda, it's one of those love and hate things. Like, I love the shit because on the freeway, it's smooth as shit. Like, it's smooth. The thing that I hate about it, and I don't know if this is just Nissan or if this is any other car that has CVT, but in the summertime, when it's hot, this shit struggles. Like, I don't know what's wrong with it. Like, it's about to die or something, but I don't know. Y'all need to figure it out. Like, that's just one thing that I hate about the CVT, is that really in the summer when it's hot, I don't know if it's the fluid or something, but when it's hot, when I'm driving, like, this shit be struggling, like, if it's about to give up. Number three, I think this is more of a Nissan thing versus the Nissan Altima, but I'm gonna say it anyway. Nissan, y'all need to do better as far as the TPMS system that y'all got on these cars. And what I'm saying is, the light keeps coming on. And at first, when it came on, I thought one of my tires was low, so I got it, you know, got it checked out, but my tires is good. And I got it checked and everything is good. But the problem is, I have another Nissan, I have a Nissan Titan, and it does the same shit. So Nissan, y'all need to fix that, because this ain't the first time that that tire light comes on another Nissan. So that, I think that's more of a Nissan versus a Nissan Altima, but it's still a Nissan, so Nissan, y'all need to get that shit checked out. Number four, what I don't like about this car is these ugly ass wheels that come stock on these cars. They ugly, they don't look right. Now, you get some of these cars, like the Nissans, the new Nissans, the Honda Accord, the Toyota Camrys, the sport models, you know, the sporty looking cars that have the stock but nice sport looking wheels. I feel that Nissan could have did the same shit with that, because, you know, rims is expensive. You know, if they came out with a sport looking wheel, like, all you gotta do is put some window tint, you know, maybe lower the car a little bit, and you set. But now I got the window tint, you know, I got my front windshield done. You know, eventually I want to get some other things done to the car, but now I'm gonna have to get some wheels, because these wheels, it just throws the entire car off. These shits is ugly. So Nissan, y'all could have did a little better with the design on these wheels, because these look like old ass grandma wheels. And the fifth thing that I didn't like about this car, that I really was gonna replace anyway, but I'm gonna tell y'all anyway, was the radio. The radio, I didn't like it, because for one, it didn't have Bluetooth. It had an auxiliary cord, which was cool, but you know how after a while the auxiliary, you know, it starts either cutting out on each side or it gets like really scratchy. And that's what the shit started doing. And I was replacing cords and it was still doing the same thing. So I ended up replacing the entire head unit. I got a Pioneer touchscreen now. But I think that, and they could have did better with that, because I've been in other 2010s, other vehicles, and they came with Bluetooth. So I feel that they could have did a little bit better as far as the design on just the things that they put into this car. Y'all could have put in Bluetooth. At least something, you know, a little bit more than what y'all had in here.
Embarrassing, man. My damn gimbal done died.
Hey, but real quick, if you guys are looking into video photography, or if you guys just do it, you know, for fun, you know, shooting video, shooting, you know, vlogs or whatever, hey, I highly recommend getting one of these or something like this, video stabilizer. Hey, these right here make your videos extra crispy, man. I'm telling you, best investment that I've spent so far. I'll put the link in the description for this. You guys can definitely check it out and, you know, definitely get one of these. Hey, but I appreciate you guys watching my video, man. Make sure you guys like, share, and subscribe. And just follow the movement, baby. Hey, it's just making it from the top from here. So make sure you guys like, make sure you guys go subscribe, and I'm out.